Hello, I am Benoît Caillot, head of the ICECOMS team, and I am presenting the objective, result, and project of the team. First, let us pay attention to the positioning, composition, and environment of the team. The ICECOMS team focuses on hybrid systems modeling and verification in general, and particularly on the design of hybrid systems modeling languages. We put a particular emphasis on the scalability and reusability of models. For this reason, we are interested in differential algebraic equations, or DAEs, their multimode or switched extensions, and of course, the Modelica language. Regarding the verification of hybrid systems, we focus on the use of proof assistance to prove safety properties. Our main field of application is to provide methods and tools to support the engineering of physics-dominated systems. Most of our collaborations are with energy and transport industries. The ICECOMS team is composed of three permanent researchers, one administrative assistant, one postdoc, two engineers, and three PhD students. The team is funded thanks to several projects. The IPL Model Escape project, a national network funded by INRIA and gathering three teams from INRIA, three teams from several higher education institutions. The FUI Model Escape project, that can be seen as the industrial counterpart of the first project, with industrial partners such as Dassault Systèmes, EDF, and ENGIE. The focus of both projects is on the scalability of hybrid systems modeling, simulation, and verification. The Daedalus Technological Development Action supports one software engineer with the objective, the consolidation of our ISAMDAE software. And the close bilateral collaboration with Safran on model-based system engineering. Let us continue with the scientific achievements. In 2017, we have completed a long-term goal, the publication of a monograph on contract-based design formalisms and methods. The aim of the book is to provide contract theories supporting systems engineering tasks whenever several stakeholders have to collaborate on a common goal, namely the design of a cyber-physical system. A typical situation is an integrator and one or several suppliers. The idea of contracts in computer science can be traced back in the literature to the 70s and in programming languages to the 80s, for instance, with the Eiffel language by Meyer. In the 2000s, it can be found in different forms to specify reactive systems. For instance, interface automata by Enzinger or model transition systems by Larsen are two remarkable instances of this idea. The topic then flourished, and by 2015, a fair number of interfaces have been proposed in the literature. Our main contribution is a contract meta-theory, where contracts characterize the possible environments in which a component is expected to live and its expected behavior. Contracts come with several relations and composition operators. Thanks to these operators, contracts can be put together to form an architecture and then compared to a top-level contract, or conversely, decomposed into contracts applicable to lower-level components. The interesting property of contract theories is that they can be specialized in different ways, and several known contract theories can be cast as instances of a contract meta-theory. We have proof that this is the case of Enzinger's interface automata, the deterministic subset of Larsen's model transition system, but also assumed guarantee contracts and even relay guarantee contracts. The contract meta theory should not be seen as a unification of all these formalisms, but as a clarification of the jungle of contract theories. We now switch to a different topic, hybrid systems verification. Our first contribution is the verification of the ACAS-X a new generation of airborne collision avoidance system. The purpose of an ACAS is to deliver to the pilot simple maneuver advisories in the vertical plane whenever another aircraft may represent a collision threat. The objective of this new generation of ACAS is to deliver fewer false alarms in dense traffic situations while improving the overall safety of the system. The verification consisted in proving that no aircraft can enter a protection cylinder around each aircraft under the assumption that pilots do follow the advisories within a given time frame. The contribution consists of a hybrid model of the simplified flight mechanics plus the pilot latency plus all possible advisories. This results in a huge combinatorics of modes, and for each case, a proof obligation has been produced. Each proof obligation is a safety property that is discharged by proving an invariance property. Interestingly, several unsafe cases have been detected, not because the ACASX system is incorrect, but because the model was too imprecise. All this is in a journal paper that appeared in 2017. Recall that a manifold is said to be an invariant of a dynamical system if and only if, once you are on the manifold, the dynamics will remain on the manifold forever. Now, how do you prove that a given manifold is an invariant? Consider the case of a polynomial dynamical system and of algebraic or semi-algebraic sets defined by polynomial equations and respectively polynomial inequalities. The objective is to provide sound proof rules with which you can prove whether the set is an invariant of the dynamics or not. In a journal paper, we have established a hierarchy of proof rules. Some were already known and some were new. These rules have been ordered by their proof power. Consider this case where the manifold is defined by a polynomial with a singularity. Here the singularity is that the gradient of the polynomial is zero at some point. Because of this, the well-known Lie criterion cannot be used to prove the invariance. On the other hand, more powerful proof rules derived from the Lie criterion are applicable. Consider another case where the flow is parallel to a manifold of dimension 2. It turns out that only one of these three proof rules is applicable. We have considered a suite of test cases of increasing difficulty. The figure gives the number of test cases passed with each proof rule and the average computation time per test case. You can see that the less powerful proof rules are not the less computationally intensive ones. On the contrary, we can notice that the most general rule for algebraic sets, the DRI rule, is the least computationally intensive of all the rules applicable only to algebraic sets. Let us move to the third and main research topic of the team on multimode DAE systems. Why differential algebraic equations rather than ordinary differential equations? Consider the following system: an electric motor coupled to a flywheel. The top figure is a Modelica model where components enclose algebraic or differential algebraic equations. Connectors between components are linear equations resulting from the Kirchhoff laws and the principle of mechanics. The structure of the model exactly reflects the physical system architecture. Consider now a Simulink model of the very same system. It has not been possible to organize it in a way that resembles the physical architecture of the system. What this example tells us is that DAEs support reusability and enable a physical component-based modeling methodology. This is not the case for ODEs. Several languages and tools are based on DAEs, Modelica, but also proprietary languages and tools such as MSIM, Simscape, and even Mathematica. Interestingly, all these tools allow the definition of multimode or switched DAEs, where equations can be enabled or disabled dynamically depending on the state of the system. Now, DAEs come with their own difficulties. The main one is that simulation code generation is more difficult because a structural analysis has to be performed in order to determine and possibly decrease the differentiation index of the system. Moreover, structural analysis at compile time is essential for debugging models and for the generation of high-performance simulation code. Multimode DAEs come with additional difficulties. The main one is that the literature on this topic is scarce, and even the mathematical concepts of solution of multimode DAEs have not been completely explored. Here is an example of one such difficulty. Consider two flywheels interconnected by a clutch. This clutch is considered to be ideal, meaning that it has two modes, disengaged, where zero torque is transmitted, and engaged, where slippage is zero. The transition between these two modes is deemed instantaneous. You have the corresponding model in Modelica. The two first equations are the dynamics of the flywheels. The third equation describes the behavior of the clutch. The last equation sets the sum of the torques to be zero. This is a correct multimode DAE model, admitting a unique solution. And yet, all Modelica tools we had the opportunity to test crash with a division by zero error. The difficulty with this model is twofold. First, the differentiation index varies from 0 to 1 when switching from the disengaged to the engaged mode. Second, at the instant of switching, the speeds are discontinuous and therefore the torques are Dirac measures. The structural analysis of a multimode DAE system consists in the determination for each mode of a number of times each equation has to be differentiated in order to have a structurally non-singular Jacobian. This is the basic idea of index reduction. We have contributed two results on this topic. First, a theory of multimode DAE systems based on non-standard analysis. Second, a BDD-based algorithm solving the structural analysis problem for all modes at once, meaning that no enumeration of the modes has to be made. Our implicit BDD-based structural analysis algorithm has been implemented in a software prototype. We obtained very promising experimental results with good scalability. For instance, on a thermal model of an office building with double flow ventilation, we have been able to scale up to 150 rooms, which amounts to more than 2,500 equations and 10 to the power 115 modes. The main difficulty with multimode DAEs is how to handle mode switchings. We have proposed a structural analysis of mode changes. The difficulty is how to deal with conflicts between the dynamics before the mode change and consistency equations after the mode change. The key idea is to introduce an infinitesimal delay on some new enabled equations whenever a structural overdetermination occurs. Non-standard analysis really helps us to do this. To summarize, this work takes place in the context of an intense collaboration with Dassault Systèmes on Modelica and their tool, Daimola. We have developed a structural analysis library for multimode DAE systems. It is called ISAMDAE. And we have published four papers on this topic. The last one is a long journal paper detailing our multimode DIE theory. Let us have a technical focus on why our implicit structural analysis algorithm scales up nicely. Recall that the structural analysis consists in two main steps. The index reduction followed by a block triangular decomposition of the resulting system of equations. For the index reduction, we use a multimode generalization of the sigma method by John Price. This method consists in solving two problems. First, a primal problem, that is the computation for each mode of a maximal weight transverse of a bipartite graph. And second, a dual problem, that is a simple integer linear programming problem for computing the differentiation order of the leading equations and variables. It turns out that experimentally, 95% of the computation time is spent in the primal problem. In our algorithm, the primal problem consists in the computation of four functions of the modes: the set of all transverses as a characteristic function, a weight function, an argmax function, and a selection of one maximal weight transverse for each mode. The key idea is to exploit the sparsity of the Boolean and arithmetic formulas that results from the sparsity of the model itself. For this, we use a reduced block triangular form, or RBTF decomposition, of the formulas. Consider a formula phi over x union y. X is a small and well-chosen set of variables. We start by splitting the formula in two parts. First, phi x, that depends on x and also y, and the second part, phi x bar, that does not depend on x. Consider phi x. It depends on x and y, but since x is supposed to be small and the formula is sparse, phi x is most often also small. We eliminate variables in x by existential quantifier elimination and combine the result with phi x bar. We obtain a formula on y only. In the case of Boolean formulas, this formula is equisatisfiable with the original formula. To control the decomposition, we use greedy heuristics based on a cost model called weighted adjacency propagation, or WAP. With FISAMDAE, we obtained, on many examples, a reduction in memory and time consumption by a factor 100 or higher. Let us move to the project for the coming 4 years. On multimode DIEs, we want to complete the development of FISAMDAE up to an industrial transfer of the tool itself or of the algorithms. For this, we have the support of a software engineer, Bertrand Provost. We want to continue our work on the scalability of the structural analysis. This is part of Joanne Thibault's PhD. We want to work on a modular structural analysis method. This would be a first step towards a genuine separate compilation of Modelica. Regarding non-smooth dynamical systems, we want to focus on the structural analysis of complementarity systems. Complementarity systems can be seen as a class of multimode DIEs with additional structure. They are an appropriate mathematical framework for many physical systems, for example in mechanics, thermodynamics, or electronics. There are dedicated numerical schemes that can deal with Zeno behavior and sliding modes, for instance, the Moro sweeping process. The objective for us is a finer structural analysis for transforming models into the structure required by these solvers. This is part of Christel Kozeli's PhD thesis. Regarding the verification of hybrid systems, we want to work on piecewise systems with a different point of view, where hybrid systems are seen as essentially continuous. Discrete jumps are made across crises, that is, non-regular constraints in the state space. You can view the dynamics as a trajectory on a rigid origami instead of a flat space. Regarding the simulation of large systems, we are interested in a QSS-based distributed simulation. QSS stands for quantized state systems, and the basic principle is a state-space discretization rather than a classical time discretization. This allows to desynchronize the simulation of subsystems and seems appropriate for the simulation of large systems. Our objective is to exploit the result of a structural analysis to partition a system so that we can achieve good performances when using QSS-based distributed simulation. Last but not least, we are interested in other uses of structural analysis. One of them is to exploit a structural analysis to synthesize diagnosers from a multimode DIE model. The applications are the detection of failures or aging of components. This last topic is dependent on industrial collaboration opportunities. I thank you for your attention.